Oh yeah!
Time to fail fucking miserably.
Alright, I got a few lore things to go over before we can move from the current screen that we're on. It was 6 months ago that Ilaria Feywing, known throughout the Kingdom of Skylark as the Master, took all of you in as pupils. The old elf woman's skill in magic, combat, and survival are legendary. She trained Marigold the Brave, who slew the infamous Great Blue Dragon Dyraxthes, and Blauton Buttertree, who closed the demon portal of Nargoth, and so many other famous heroes. Of all the would-be treasure seekers, mercenaries, and do-gooders that came across her doorstep begging for her wisdom, it was you who were selected by Ilaria. Why did you come to the Master's Mansion before beginning your life of adventure? Answer from left to right, starting with you, CD. You can type it out if you want. You don't have to say it.
Yeet.
Hold on.
Okie doke.
Okay, there we go. I just had to practice something. Okay. I came along searching out for help in preparing myself for whatever my god may be throwing my way. And in hopes to ready myself and better myself for any sort of potential combat that might come up during my trials and travels.
Interesting. Okay. Now you, the orc.
Mammy.
Oh, right. I was in this pub or some shit like that. I don't know. I was drunk as hell. And I heard there was some flying booty over here.
Okay, then. And you, the little wizard. Halfling, whatever you are.
I was sitting in a tree one day when a bird picked me up and dropped me off at the doorstep. I don't know why I'm here. But the fates have brought me here, and so shall it.
What?
Okay, then. And the Goliaths, what about you?
I wish to be a match for my former rival, Thokon, who is a tribal leader in a foreign tribe where I grew up.
I see.
Did you say Gohan?
Did I?
I'm trying to Thokon. Gohan now.
That's what it sounded like I said, yes. And you, centaur person.
I was in the local area performing a rather successful little, you know, show in the nearby taverns. After my set, enjoying many, many drinks, I quite literally stumbled through her door. Instead of having me, you know, coded away by the guards, saw some potential in me fighting the guards, and I have stuck around since then.
Interesting. And last but not least, the little goblin.
Isn't that everyone?
That's you.
Yeah. Yeah.
I know it is. I had to find the... Alright.
Zandy Strange Cheek. I like it.
Very interesting answers, you six. I foresee a very interesting future months. Especially with you, Centaur. That was a very inspiring answer.
Indeed. Nothing says inspiration like drunkenly stumbling through a door.
Stampeding through a door.
I don't know if you'd call it stampeding. A drunk horse is not very nimble.
Okay. Over the last half year, you've learned Ilaria Feywing is intense, but fair and encouraging. Though she is over 8 centuries old, her elf blood keeps her thin, lithe, and youthful, which allows her to enforce your rigorous training regimen. You are each learning different skills in magic, combat, and more, but you all take your meals together. One day, you are sitting at a long dining table, enjoying a hot breakfast together. Ilaria puts down her porridge spoon and stands up, looking you all in the eyes, her golden hair framing her own green orbs. She cracks a smile as she begins speaking. It is time for your first test in real combat. We have a rat infestation in the basement. A giant rat infestation. I managed to get them contained in the larder, but they'll soon eat through all our supplies and the door itself if you don't go down there to exterminate. Her green eyes twinkle with mischievous delight as she adds, I also seem to have misplaced the key to the larder after locking them in. So you'll have to get through the door and past the barricade I set up before you can get to the rats. The master sits back down in her chair and puts a spoonful of porridge to her lips. Before actually taking a bite, she looks at all of you and says, Well, what are you waiting for? You know by now that that is your cue to head down to the basement. What do you do?
You
said I will grab what's left of my bowl, just down it as quick as I can, and start running towards the basement.
Okay.
You said you lost the key?
Yes, I do not know where it is. I really do need you to go down to the basement, though.
To insight on that.
Okay, go ahead and... hold on. I'm going to go ahead and say that succeeds, but just barely. And you can tell she is not fully telling the truth. She possibly may know where the key is. You're not entirely sure. But she is not telling the truth about not knowing where it is.
I have invisible helper. I'd like to send him to find...
Okay, well, you can try.
What did I roll?
You just click the spell in your spell sheet. If it's a spell. I think it's a spell.
I am not seeing my character sheet.
Go to the journal. Second tab.
Just click that and then go to your character name.
Nunga Nunga.
Would it be in bad standing if we, you know, had the orc ran the door down?
That is an option if you wanted to try that.
I was going to partition you to do it.
Yeah, I that is how I kind of arrived here. I know I can do it. You know, Leroy charged through the door.
Or should I try to intimidate her into telling the truth?
She will not be affected by that.
Fuck you. You can't tell me what to do.
I'm reading what the spell does. You didn't have to click it twice, three times, four times. I was just saying it as I scrolled up. The servant seems unable to find the key. Although it does seem to indicate that it is somewhere near Ilaria.
Anyone else against me just trying to horsey kick the door down?
Or if you just want to do that,
you can
hammer.
Go ahead.
Or you guys want to try to look for it?
Yeah, I think Sadu's going to go for the straightforward approach, slamming on the door with the centaur.
If that's what you want to do.
All right. So what I do?
You want me to swing my hammer at it, or what? Or you want to try to horse kick it?
I want to try and horse kick the door. So I'm guessing that'd be a strength roll.
Hold on one second.
Do we got combined strength for this, or what?
You approach the basement steps. The steps of Ilaria's mansion lead to a stone passage and ding in a locked wooden door. You know that beyond the door is a large larder filled with all manner of cheese, grains, meat, and produce. The rats inside could live like royalty for months on all the foods within. What would you like to do?
Donkey punch.
The tech magic might be a good idea before I kick an exploding door.
You do not sense anything.
I don't think I've got anything spell-wise that would make this.
Are you going to just kick the door, or are you going to do something else?
I believe I'm going to horse kick the door unless anyone else has got an idea.
Yeah, I got nothing. I'm just going to assist you with my greatsword.
So would I get any kind of bonus to this since I'm a centaur?
If you are being assisted, you could say someone's assisting you, and then whoever has the lowest or whoever has the higher strength score rolls with advantage.
Also, guidance.
Yep, that works too.
I guess I wish to assist by swinging my hammer.
Okay, well, now the door is clearly lit up so you can examine it. Doesn't really do much other than making the door very bright and very clear to the sight.
Well, now it's going to look pretty when we, you know, splinter it.
We can see.
All right, whoever will be knocking down, I'll go and do guidance on, and they have an extra d4 to roll.
All right, so that'd be me. So how do I roll that then?
All right, in the chat, you can do, for example, in the chat.
All right.
Without the period, of course.
I just go to the left.
That also works.
First off, Zandy being the ever distrusting goblin that she is going to roll a perception check on the door. And she does not notice anything off looking at the door that could be dangerous in any way. To her, it appears to be a normal door.
Oh, I could have gone into it.
Well, in that case, let's see. So do I roll the d4 first and then do my strength roll?
You can do it either way if you want.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, well, that helped out a fucking lot.
It could be the difference between seven. Fail and succeed.
Didn't you say anyone assisting has to roll?
No, the assister just gives advantage for the roll. You can roll that again.
Oh, sorry.
And the higher number. Advantage.
Yeah.
Well, you can just roll it a second time, regular, and then the higher number.
All right.
Okay, well, 6 plus 1, you kick the door. Nothing happens. It rattles a bit in its frame, but that's about it.
Can I attempt to break it with my hammer? My giant fucking hammer.
I mean, we could just do this until the end of time, couldn't we?
Which of you had the higher strength score, by the way? Brody or Nunga Nunga?
I think mine's 15.
I have, like, 18 or 17?
I've got, I think, 18.
Guidance.
With a +4 or something.
Yeah.
Nunga Nunga, you have a 17, and Brody, you have a 15. So it actually would have been Brody assisting Nunga Nunga to give advantage.
Alright.
Okay, so I just D20 and a D4?
Yeah. No, you roll strength, so it would be...
So you just click on your little strength thing in your bio?
What?
Yeah.
Okay.
So we'll count that Brody's thing didn't roll.
Fucking shit!
Okay, roll it again. Because you have advantage from Brody assisting you.
Yep.
And also a D4.
11.
And roll the D4.
That, whoops. Wait.
Yeah, that's it.
Why is that thing a triangle?
Because that's what a D4 is.
Yeah, it's basically a triangle.
A pyramid, but yes. The door rattles and looks like it almost opens before it settles back in its frame again.
Who knows, Fireball?
Frustrated and still distrustful of the door, Zandy is again going to make a
guidance check.
Okay, I will D4 that.
Guys, this is a great fucking cantrip.
Actually,
is there a limit on how many times you can do that? Or
no, I can do it as
actually,
much as I want.
It doesn't even need the guidance. Zandy, before Brody or Nunga Nunga can swing again, points at a small nozzle just above the handle of the door. A suspicious looking nozzle.
What?
And
guidance.
Can I light up the nozzle?
Don't even need it. Investigating the nozzle, she discovers that it is connected to a canister of gas hidden inside the door. Triggered to spray when the door is opened or unlocked.
Hmm.
So yeah, I was waiting for you guys to succeed so I could say that you had been poisoned. But you let me get a chance in for Zandy to mention that that was there.
This is why I didn't agree with you playing a character.
Because you would know that you're dead. It's basically, are you going to let us die?
It wouldn't have killed you.
Probably not.
I suggest everyone to go back upstairs.
Well, the door ain't open. We're fine here.
Yeah, it's not open yet.
I want to stick my unseen servant back on the door.
I got a roll. See, I only know what it takes to actually succeed on these things. I can play dumb on whether they exist or not. That is just enough to disarm the poison trap using the thieves' tools. So, the trap is now disarmed, and you can proceed as normal trying to break the door down.
I shall swing
or,
again.
Or, if you ask, Zandy could potentially pick the lock as well.
I want to swing again.
Okie dokie. Do that with advantage.
I really do.
You can just constantly pass that. That is the dumbest thing.
Break the door down.
Fucking goddamn it.
You still have advantage from being assisted.
Rolled again. I got you.
Come on!
Guidance.
Can I send my unseen servant to run into?
No, that would not do anything. Even with the guidance, it's still not enough.
Damn it. All right. Can I try to kick it again then?
You could.
All right, fuck it. Kicking it.
Got okay, it. That actually gets it open.
Okay.
So we beat the fuck out of the door, and eventually I need to finally kick it open.
I'm just picturing a fucking horse and some dumbass just swinging at a fucking door.
The door breaks open, and the poison trap attempts to trigger, but nothing happens. Mm-hmm. You are now in a small hallway just outside of a larder. You cannot see very far in front of you due to how dark it is.
Mr. Light.
But you can hear. What is your passive perception, everyone?
I'll pull that up. Mine's 11.
13.
Where do I see that?
I am also going to light up my shirt.
Passive perception. Wisdom, just below your stat rolls.
I myself have dark vision, but I also do light as well.
Okay.
On my shield.
20-foot radius, and then dim light for another 20 feet. So, hold on a second.
Does everyone have a fucking light?
I don't need... Sandy doesn't need one because she has dark vision, but...
I also have dark vision as well, but...
Well, I don't, so I'm lighting my shirt up.
I think I do?
10, 15, 20...
I have a torch, but do I need to use a tinder box to light it?
You can now see as far as there. You see right in front of you, there are boxes stacked basically to the ceiling. You can move as you want, by the way. There's nothing stopping you. Just remember that this door is wide enough for only one person to move through at a time.
So I'm hearing is blast my bagpipes and charge in.
If you want to.
So how far can I see if I move up to these boxes?
Shield up, moving into the room. Light coming from the shield.
I can't march over there somewhere.
With the light, you can see boxes on your right and left, again, stacked to the ceiling, as well as still the boxes in front of you. You seem to be surrounded by boxes with no way visible to get past them.
How far can I move?
You have unlimited movement unless we're in combat, okay. So.
Unga, move boxes.
Alright, I want to smash this wall down.
Guys. That box right there, exactly? The one right in front of you?
Yeah.
You will find that there is a massive hole in that box, and it crumbles fairly easily.
So can we get through now?
Yes, that box is now clear, freeing up a 5x5 space for you to move.
And I can see in the dark, right?
Yes.
Alright, let's,
Presumably I'm using my torch.
Thanks to the lights. However... Go on, what were you saying?
Presumably I'm using my torch.
Well...
You can move your character, Crow.
Well, Crow did Dancing Light when we came in. Whatever the fuck that would do.
It just summoned four lights around him.
Oh. Crow, get in there.
Only around him and not us.
Yeah, and I made my shirt glow.
Someone with a light. Someone with a light.
I sent my unseen servant in there first.
Does he have lights?
No, he doesn't have lights. He just went in.
The sound of the rats skittering gets louder.
I'm going to go ahead and step into the door with my light.
And ahead of you, past the box that you just busted, you can see something rummaging through a sack. You can't see exactly what it is, but you can see it rummaging through the stack, or through the sack. What do you do?
I'm going to have my unseen servant go over and kick
it. That has already faded. You have not casted it again.
Then in that case, I'm going to throw
the axe. How many spell slots do you have?
Me?
Yes.
I'll say a servant.
Last total two?
Okay.
I'd like to go ahead and make a perception check.
Okay.
Guidance and also D4 from Hunter's Intuition, which is a racial thing.
You can guidance yourself?
Yeah.
You gotta Okey-doke. Teach yourself how to do something.
Well, 16.
What are you? Are you listening or?
Listening, see if I can figure out if there's anything else that's moving around other than, like, maybe if I can figure out, like, trying to think of how to word it, how many there might be and where they might be.
Well, you can see one just off to the side from your position, CD.
Yeah.
You can see this rat diagonally from the box. No one else can see it currently. So pretend you don't see that, guys.
But I stick an unseen servant to kick.
The unseen servant cannot attack, so...
Can he poke it with a stick?
No, it's not attacking. It's just kicking.
That kicking counts as an unarmed attack.
Can he poke it with
a stick? Which it cannot do.
Okay, can I poke it with a stick?
It could try.
I want to try and poke it with a stick.
Okay, well, time to roll initiative then. So go ahead and make sure you have your token selected. Then go into your character sheet and roll initiative.
Where I go to roll for that?
Do we all just crow.
It's on your character sheet between armor class and speed, just above your hit points.
That's eight. Do we all have to roll for it or just him?
Everyone.
Oh.
All right.
What? Why do we all have to?
All right, I got a four.
Because that just started the fight. It pissed off the rat.
But it was unseen.
It got poked with a stick.
And?
The stick wasn't unseen.
Where is initiative again?
Where is the initiative middle counter?
At the top.
There's a button for it that you select.
Yeah, that's where I'm
I think
looking
it's near
at
the bottom.
Buttons. Oh, there it is.
Do you have a character open, Jinx?
Yeah, my character sheet's open.
Select your token.
I already did.
Middle of it. Right below your name and shit. In the middle, between armor class and speed.
Just above hit points. There you go. Alright. That's everyone except for Crow, who has yet to move his token. Even...
I have lost.
I'll just move him for him.
Select your token. You got that far?
Open
your character sheet.
I'm looking at character sheet.
Go to the scroll all the way up on it. Go to the middle of it. Like, the horizontal middle of it.
The shield.
And then go down.
Just above your current hit points.
I don't see current hit points.
What do you see?
cat trips, advantage, normal, disadvantage, core, bio spells, public to GM.
It's right below advantage.
I know where you're at. Like on the right, is your spells little button there red?
You want core to be red rather than spells.
Okay, my bad.
There you are. That's where your initiative is, in the middle.
A whole three.
All right, hot just damn. Let me get the rats on the...
Nat 20.
Useless.
Just let me get the... let me get the rats on the initiative here.
Fuck yo rats.
All right, that's a 12. Oops. All right.
Need to add Crow to the sheet. The turn order.
Oh.
I didn't have his token selected.
All right, that's fine.
Yeah, you can right click on the token and add to turn order as a DM.
Okay. So, Crow, you get the first turn. You can only see one rat currently, although you can detect the presence. You can see the presence of another rat digging through a moving bag ahead of you, just past your orc friend. Oh, yeah, orc friend here. So, what do you do?
Say we only got the one box blown out, right?
Yeah,
just that box currently has been right, destroyed.
Mark it, maybe. There, that one's busted.
You could try to check for other boxes that could be destroyed. Is a possible thing that you could do.
I want to go ahead and detect magic.
You don't detect anything magic.
Then I'm going to walk over and actually start attacking.
Okay. You can move. One moment. You can move up to 25 feet. Attempting to move through an ally counts as double movement. So to get past Nunga Nunga, you would need to move 10 feet rather than just the 5 feet through his space. Every box counts as 5 feet.
I want to start attacking boxes around me.
Okay, where are you going to move to do that?
To my left.
You're not left. Air boxes.
So you're going to go this way. Actually, just draw the path you want to go and I'll move you, since you don't seem to be able to figure out how to move your token. You don't have the arrow selected on the left, so you have the drawing tool, not the arrow.
Okay.
Or that's Bammy doing that. Damn it, stop it, Bammy. Now select your token, which is this one. And then you can drag it. If you're moving through another token, that counts as double move speed. Otherwise, nope, you can't move there.
You're on a box.
Yeah, you can't.
You can go there, you just have to go back one square.
Yeah, you can go right there.
Deal.
You're doing what?
Attacking the box.
That nothing happens except for the box seems to shave off a few chips of wood, so to speak. That box seems solid and unbreakable for your current strength. Even though you didn't roll an attack. You don't have to, because the boxes, they're boxes. All right, you moved 10 feet and attempted to an attack a box. What else are you doing? You can move back to where you started, or you can end your turn, basically.
I'm ending my turn.
All right. Pavel, it is your turn.
Okay.
You know that the box right in front of Nunga is okay. Because he moved diagonally, he doesn't have to move double. So,
busted.
For future reference, if you're moving diagonally past an ally, it does not count as double movement.
All right. It just counts like moving one square.
If you're moving through an ally, though, that is double movement.
All right, this rat here. Go ahead and have him make a dex save as I'm going to bring out my holy symbol and blazing shield. I'm going to be casting Sacred Flame.
All right.
That is max damage. Nice.
DC 13?
Yeah.
Oof. It
nothing
succeeds.
At all then. Okay, that's unfortunate. Okay. Don't think I really have much of anything I can do as bonus action that is really needed right now, so I'm just going to go ahead and step over to there, and that'll be it.
Alright, next is Zandy.
So you can move at any time, just you have a maximum per turn?
You can during initiative, you can only move during your turn.
No, yeah, that's what I'm saying, like any time during
Yeah, you can split up your movement.
Okay.
Alright, Zandy is going to move to here, and...
Also, don't forget to account for my light in my new position when you can.
She is going to examine the room, focused mainly on the box in front of her. And she notices that this one, like the one next to Nunga, is broken. Shut up. I'm doing the best I can, given that you guys needed a rogue with thieves' tools on your...
I mean, eventually we would have got through the door without you.
We did get
See, I didn't even make it for that. I didn't know the door was trapped when I made this character.
But you knew that box.
Because I hadn't read that far yet. I just knew that none of you had thieves' tools, and thieves' tools are an incredibly important thing to have. All right.
I have bagpipes. That's all I need. And a disguise kit, because apparently, you know, no one will notice the centaur running around with a mask on.
Just TF2 spy.
Yeah,
pretty much.
She does slide through the hole in this box. I started here. That's 5, 10, 15 movement. Then she moves to here and will make an attack at this rat.
Oh.
That misses. Wow. And she cannot attack again currently. Or she could, but she's choosing not to. And she will end her turn there.
I hope you get the plague.
I'm sorry, what?
Nothing.
All right. Next is the rat's turns. You hear scuttling as...
That looks so stupid.
I don't know how to rotate it. The normal rotation icon is hidden. That was... Yeah, I know you can do that, but it's like I select it, and then the thing that I use to put these on it is in the way of the rotation.
Try zooming in or out.
Maybe. Oh, there it is. Okay. I got it. Okay.
You what, mate?
How far was that? Started there. 50, 20, 25, 30.
My speed is how far I can move, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep. I think that's 25.
So how many spaces could I move at the speed of 30?
Six spaces, since each space indicates 5 feet.
Okay.
There's also this ruler thing.
Yep. It's nice. So I should be able to chase down everybody we come across, because my movement is fucking 40.
Minus 30.
And I also...
Minus 25!
Mine is also 30. Five. 10, 15, 20.
Where'd that rat come from?
25. And it's going to end its turn there.
We have a lot of rats.
All right. So first off, CD.
Yes.
Wait, first of all, is this a wall or is this just where your vision got fucked?
Is what a wall? Where?
That little black mark there.
Can you not see there? Oh, I didn't have it revealed fully.
Get rid of that now?
It should be, I can clear that.
Just don't accidentally delete the that.
I have a button that just clears all drawings. Okay, so this rat is going to make an attack at you, CD. Oh,
marking that broken box.
Does a 16 hit. Miss. Okay.
I'll be deflecting that with my shield.
Actually, no, that would be a 19 because it has pack tactics.
Oh, okay, that changes things then. Okay, that does hit.
All right, and that's 4 piercing damage.
Kyle, mark the one that you walked through.
Yeah, I did. The one right in front of you.
No, this one. This one, Mr. Lady walked through.
All right, and then...
I don't think I can fit through her hole, probably.
Ha ha ha, very funny.
No,
a medium creature can attempt to squeeze through, but it would do it at disadvantage with an acrobatics check. And you do count as a medium creature, so.
Alright, that's not too bad then.
Still the rat's turn. This one is going to make an attack at Zandy, and that's a automatic crit, so that's 4 damage to Zandy. Or no, that's... Yeah, 5. I just did the math wrong. Well, and then...
No, that's 4. 3 plus 4.
Yeah, I have 9 HP, so it would be 5 health.
Oh, okay.
I put myself down to 4 health.
Okay, and then, I understand now.
This rat...
I thought you were talking about the damage.
...is also going to make an attack at Zandy, which misses. And then... That is the rat's turn. So now it is Sajuk's turn. Sajuk's, I think, is. The Goliath.
Little bitch.
Dust juking.
Go on.
So, presumably I won't be able to fit through these boxes.
You can get through the one in front of me. It's broken.
That one is open.
Smashed.
You can squeeze through this one if you do a acrobatics check with disadvantage.
Okay.
Yeah, this one is destroyed. So.
So I think I want to move, like, between these two rats up front.
You can move.
Okay.
You can move it yourself.
Yeah, you can do that.
Yeah, you can just drag your token. 5, 10, 15. Yep, you can do that. You can still move another... Let's see, what's your movement speed? You can still move another 10 feet. So that would be 2 squares still.
Whipping like that.
Oh, yeah, so you can move another...
Because you can't move through enemy spaces.
3 squares, yeah.
An additional.
So three. You can move to here.
You don't have to move now.
Yeah, you don't have to move, but you can.
Hey,
you can move to there as well.
Advice. Attack the one that's right next to me.
Well, what I was thinking was I could use my intimidation to sort of roar. Maybe scare them away or something. I don't know what to do.
Because
I got decent intimidation.
Can you do intimidation in combat, CD?
It would be a action.
You can use your action for that if you want and try to scare them.
Yeah, I think I will.
Very funny.
And I'd have a...
That would be an intimidation check on your character sheet. All right, and then it fails because pack tactics does not apply to checks and always take the left number, so it got a 4. Which rat did you do that on?
I thought I would do one on all of them, but I guess the one on my right.
So that one.
That's... Yeah, that one.
Okay. That rat is now frightened of you, and on its next turn will attempt to run away from you as far as it can go. And then it will get another saving throw to try and break the frighten. Alright, is that your turn? Are you going to use your bonus action to attack or end?
I'd probably attack the other rat that's...
Okay, so this one.
Use his action to do the intimidation. I don't think he has anything for a bonus action.
He can attack on his bonus action. I thought everyone could do that.
That's only if you're dual wielding.
Oh. Okay, well, I didn't know that.
Could I intimidate on my bonus action and attack on my main one?
I don't know. Could he do that, CD? Attack and then intimidate on his bonus action?
I'd say intimidation would be along the lines of an action.
Okay. And bonus action for things like that does not count as an action, so...
I'll just leave it at that, I guess.
What's my range? All right.
Nunga Nunga, it is your turn.
What? What is this rage counter? On my sheet?
Rage counter? Let's see.
As a barbarian, you can only go into rage so many times per, I think, long rest.
Yeah, that's how many times you can go in. You can use your rage ability before... That's how many times you can do that.
All right. So I'm guessing the same thing for my bardic inspiration, because I've seen
what's right. And then if you use them all, you then have to do a long rest before.
Okay.
Can move either through Pavel or through the Goliath for twice the movement required to move through them. You could go over to the other box and either attempt to destroy it or squeeze through it.
Unga smash.
Wasn't Miss Thief almost dead?
Yeah, she is at half HP, pretty much. Because she did not bet on the rats swarming her.
I can take care of that.
And this one's going to run away, right? That was
5, 10...
Was this one going to run away?
20. It's going to run away from specifically the Goliath. So it will go whichever direction it needs to get as far away from him as possible. On its turn, obviously.
How do you do that select thing?
Hold long click.
Yep.
Alright.
Okay, cool.
Someone done goofed.
Yep, I didn't realize that my box clicked. My bad. Can I erase that?
Yeah, you can select it and then just press delete. There you go.
I don't know which rat to attack.
Hit the one that's a rat.
You can still move there for... You have about 10 move speed left.
I have one.
15.
You had to run through.
10. 20. You have 30 move speed. You can move to there.
1. 2. 3.
Yeah, you have 30 move speed.
1, 2.
Yeah, it didn't count for 2 since you had to move through him.
That one counts as 2, yes.
Oh. All
right.
Okay, yeah, I still have 3 spaces then.
Getting to here is only 20 with the double moves, so.
All right.
Yeah, two. I miscounted. I have 2 weapons, right?
Yes, you can roll to attack with either one of them, I believe.
Are they light?
One's a hammer. He has a warhammer
and a great club.
Yeah, they unless you have a certain feat, they have to be light.
And a javelin, which I just rolled the.
So what you're saying is I can attack with that. Both, or
yeah,
twice.
Yeah, unless you had a certain feat, it has to be a light weapon in order to wield.
Or you have to take the time to put one away and draw the other.
Okay.
Which is an action.
Do I attack this rat or do I attack one of these rats?
It's whichever rat you want to attack.
Someone.
I would suggest the one that's trying to save swarming the other.
If you want a suggestion. Go there, and on this one, you would have advantage because of him.
Yep.
Okay.
Because of Hunter.
And you can get to that distance because you had 10 move speed left.
I'm going to attempt to smash it with my hammer.
On your character sheet, be sure to select advantage instead of normal, and then roll the attack. Or just roll the attack twice.
Where's attack?
You just click the weapon that you're attacking with.
It's under attacks.
Attacks and spellcasting, yeah. Sorry.
So I'm giving him advantage since we're surrounding the target?
Yep, flanking.
Yeah.
I don't even fucking...
Your weapon should be in the middle there, I believe.
It should be on core, and then below your HP, you should see a box that has... Warhammer one-handed, Warhammer two-handed, great club, javelin. There you go. A 24 will hit. Now click Warhammer two-handed in the chat. You hover it and it goes red. Click it and it will roll damage. All right, that is 6 damage to this rat.
Nunga smash rat.
And you are going to end your turn there, correct?
Nunga smash!
Sure.
Brody!
Oh yeah, Brody's time.
If you try to move through the box that Nunga moved through, you will have to do double move speed to get past your allies. If you move through the box that Zandy moved through, you will have a disadvantage acrobatics check, but you will not use double movement.
Sing these rats a song of your horse people.
I do plan on using my inspiration, but I think I can do that as a bonus action.
Yeah,
right?
that's a bonus action.
All right. So, yeah, just I'll have to do that here once I finish up. I'll just start blasting on the bagpipes for somebody. I think I only choose one person with it, right?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, I'm sorry. Going through that hole, you not only have disadvantage on the...
Yes, I think I'm going through this hole here just because...
Okay.
Either way, I'm going to get disadvantaged or have to move double speed.
Yeah, it's actually worse through this one because while you are crawling, you are counted as prone. And that gives you disadvantage on your attack rolls.
Horses can go.
And you also have to spend 15 feet of movement to get through that hole.
Yeah, as much as I would enjoy trying to see the horse crawl, let's not do that.
Let's see. So you can move through him or through him, either of which will cost 10 feet of movement.
But you have like 40 feet of movement anyway, as I said. So
I have no issue with movement. So, you know, yeah, so I'm not just setting myself in the middle here. I'm going to hop on this side.
All right. That's 15 feet total to get through there because it's 10 feet to get through him and then another 5 feet to get to this box.
All right. So then I'd still have plenty of move speed.
You started here.
Yep.
5.
40, so.
5. 15.
20.
20. Okay, yeah, yep.
So, I still got 20.
You can move four more boxes.
All right. But I think I'm going to attack this rat right here.
Okay. You do not have advantage because you are not counted as flanking. So roll a normal attack.
All right. Normal. Roll with my rapier.
Okay.
Nice.
That will definitely hit.
Hot damn.
Roll the damage by clicking.
The name.
That will kill this rat.
Yes.
Just kill the rat.
And I will use my inspiration blasting a song on my fucking pipes.
So that rat is gone.
Wait. You can still move if you want to choose someone else to inspire.
You can inspire anyone within 30 feet of him, I believe.
And that does not count as an action, so.
Yeah, it's a bonus action.
Yeah, so I think I get everybody because it says within 60 feet.
Yeah, you can choose one person within 60 feet.
Alright.
No, right.
Let's go with. Let's see, who's going next?
That would be Pimpus.
Pimpus gets your happy ass with music.
Fuck that little dwarf.
He's
fucking
a
hobbit.
Hobbit.
Leave my hobbit wizard alone. He's lighting the place up. Without him, you wouldn't see the rest.
Hobbit, actually, they were fighting it.
That's it. Let's see, my shirt's also glowing, so we still have light.
I'm not entirely sure where you guys can and can't see, so I'm just going to reveal right all of this.
Right here.
Yep. I can post that again, because I can't remember what the range was on that light.
What the hell just happened? That was weird. Bugged out when I was trying to reveal.
Oop, oh. Wait.
Target. That's about as far as everyone except for Nunga Nunga can currently see.
But I have dark vision.
Nunga, you can see over here. This pile of barrels is blocking your way from seeing around it, basically.
I don't see a pile of barrels.
Okay, well, you can't see it because it's in the dark, but it's right there. There's like a half pyramid of barrels of straw to Zandy's back. Do you end your turn, Brody?
Yeah, I don't think I can move anymore, can I?
Yeah,
after
you can.
I did the inspiration.
Yeah,
you can split up your movement.
Oh, I can move again?
Yeah, you can split up your movement.
Yep, right. You have two more boxes of movement, I believe, from there.
Well, in that
or no, case, four. You have four, because that only costs 20 to get there, so.
All right. Well, in that case, I'll hop on here, so that way maybe we can flank this rat.
That rat's running away.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, that rat's going to be running away from But if you stand there, it now has to go towards Pimpos, because it can't go through you.
There
you
go. All right,
Pimpos, block that rat.
I'm leading it to you. Put your little dick in that rat. I am blasting you music. Put your dick in that rat.
Earth to Pimpos?
I'm waiting for the turn to end.
Oh, yeah. Yep, it is now Pimpos' turn, sorry.
Yeah, but you also have, like, an extra die you can roll with your shit.
D6, I believe?
Yep.
Alright. Yeah, so, to go D6. From there, you can go past Sajuk for an extra 10 movement, or past him for an extra 10 movement, or you can just stand there and make it so the rat can't move.
Fuck the rat.
Because it can't go... You can't go diagonal...
What? I want to slap it with my staff.
So go ahead and click staff, one-handed or two-handed. It's your decision.
Hobbit dick rat pussy.
And he would have advantage on this as well.
Yep. So go ahead and roll it again just to see if you get higher. Okay. Go ahead and click where it says quarterstaff two-handed in the chat for the 21. Go ahead and click that, and it will roll damage.
Where's the D6 apply? On the attack roll or damage roll? Or
any D20 roll.
Okay.
Yep. He needs a nat 20, yeah.
Yeah.
Smack rat. Rat.
Alright, that rat loses 5 HP. And do you end your turn?
Yes, sir.
All right, Pavel, your
this
turn.
This rat and this rat are almost dead.
Can you see their health bars?
No, I'm just going off. With, I'm just going off the first dead rat.
Yeah. They do look pretty beaten up already. Basic is what you are.
I'm going to throw out a healing word towards the goblin.
Alright.
First of all, because it's all I have. 6 healing. I
think that'll that would actually overheal if that was possible. That would...
Yeah.
We TF2 now, boys.
Back to full HP.
And from there, that was my bonus action.
Gotta save the only one with hits.
I'm sure you got some beefy horse tits.
Go ahead and have the rat make a dex save.
Okay,
I wonder if he's hung like a horse.
Excellent. The answer is yes.
It will fail.
Okay.
Since you go by the left number unless it's has a damage.
That would
so.
Be...
a dead rat.
Yeah.
That's what that is a dead rat. It didn't even get a chance to run in fear. All right, is that all you're doing?
I'll go down to over there to give the goblin a badge. And that'll be it.
All right, next will be the goblin's turn.
How are you highlighting your path when you move?
While I'm dragging my token, I right click.
Oh.
I didn't know you do that.
See, right click just for me moves the map, so I don't know how to change that.
I think if you select a token first, you might be able to do that. Because it does for me too. That's how you do it. You gotta hold the token first, and then you can do that.
All right. Well, Zandy is going to make an attack at that rat that CD just moved to.
My bad.
That does hit, and because she is a rogue, she has sneak attack. This kills the rat.
So you just always count as you're doing a sneak attack?
If I roll with advantage, I get sneak attack bonus damage, assuming the attack hits.
Either advantage on the attack or have an ally within 5 feet. of Target.
Yeah.
Oh, so as long as you got somebody nearby, you're doing some extra hurt.
Yeah. However, you can only do it once per turn.
All right. Fair enough.
10. No. 5, 10. She'll stop here. And I reveal that for my... Actually, I don't have to reveal that because I can just see it. Go ahead. She will end her turn.
There's one rat. Okay,
I deleted the rat's initiative. I think they rolled...
Yeah.
The one that I rolled the initiative for died, so I have to re-add it.
Yeah, it was 12.
All right, so it would be the rat's turn after Zandy. Just one moment.
Nunga, nunga.
I guess this is why you add them all as their own initiative, really, CD.
Yep.
All right.
I usually just have one specific type for each. It's like certain situations.
5, 10, 15.
Well, I feel like there's a rat on the screen.
Hey, look.
25. 30. 5. 10. 15.
But that's a box.
And it can jump out of the box. I'm going to say that just because I'm too lazy to consider terrain. It's actually a broken box, so it's on the floor. Anyway, this rat, despite looking beat up and sad, is going to make an attack at you, Orc. Does a 17 hit? Yes, a 17 hits because your AC is only 12.
Does he have disadvantage since he's surrounded?
No. When I roll as a animal, it's always the left number unless they have advantage. And then it's the highest.
Why does he have such low AC as a barbarian?
I don't know. Let's see.
Is his AC set up right? It should be his con plus dex with a base of 10.
His con modifier is 2. His dex modifier is 0.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. It is that low then.
And he did not pick any... He did not pick any armor as a He didn't get any armor as a barbarian, so...
Mm-hmm.
And he didn't get any armor through his starting
I told
background.
You, muscle.
Because he is raging, that will be halved.
You raged? Raging. Did you say you raged, Bammy?
I think he raged.
No.
Oh,
no?
Okay. I was trying to remember on that.
That is 4 damage, then.
Do I have to change this on my thing?
You can highlight your token, and then where it says 14, you can just type -4. Yep, there you go.
I just did it on my sheet.
Okay. And then this rat will attack you, Pavel. All
right.
I have to pull up its sheet again.
Squawk, squawk.
Does a 16 hit?
That will miss.
All right.
With my shield.
And that is the rat's turn stunned. Because this one could move, but there's not really anywhere it can go. So
it would also have a attack opportunity from the two.
Yep. There. All right. Next turn. Now it is your turn, Sajuk.
All right. So if I were to move here, would the rat be able to get around me?
Nope. You would just be in front of the rat.
And so they can't move through.
Could it not move here?
It cannot move diagonal if there is an enemy in the way.
Oh.
Okay. All right.
And there's no ally. If there's an enemy and no ally, it can't move diagonally.
Think I'll
through that enemy.
Move here and cut him off.
Alright. Are you going to attack?
Yeah. My greatsword, I think.
Goliath dick rat pussy.
Just go ahead and click the greatsword on your character sheet. A 16 will hit. Go ahead and roll that damage.
In the chat on the right.
13, this kills the rat.
All right, so we're just fucking these things up now.
Meanwhile, a fucking hammer slamming on one doesn't kill it.
Yeah, fuck you and your hammer.
You
I
had
20 stick.
You got a pretty low roll on your damage, to be fair. Is that all you're doing, Sajuk?
I mean,
you still have some movement.
Max. How many more spaces do I got?
You were here, I think. No, you were here.
Each space was 5. You have.
You were there. You moved 15 to get to here, so you have another 15, which is 3 spaces. Or if you want to move to here, that would be 2 spaces, since you can go diagonally. All right, you are now flanking that giant rat, and you end your turn.
Yep.
All right. Barbarian orc.
Nunga nunga.
Are you going to move or smack the rat again? Okay.
Can I attack that rat like this, or do I need to move one more?
What?
Can I attack that rat, or do I need to move one more?
You can attack diagonally, yes.
I want to smash that rat.
Alright. Go ahead and roll the attack.
Would not
be with advantage, though, because you are not flanking it. Only Pavel still not flanking.
Well, fuck you, then.
Only Pavel and Sajuk are currently flanking it because they are across from each other token-wise.
Hello? Roll? What the fuck?
There you go. A 16 will hit. Go ahead and roll damage. 12. Okay, that kills this rat. There's just the one left that you know of.
How far did I move? I don't even remember.
You started here. 5, 10, 15, 20.
Yep.
I'm gonna move this way.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm done.
All right, next is Brody.
All right. Oh, so I'm here. I might as well move over to this rat. And I am going to horse stomp the shit out of it. Because my hooves are a natural weapon.
Actually, at this point, you guys can see pretty much everything except for behind these casks here.
I'm looking at, I have my centaur page thing pulled up. Who's our natural melee weapon? Would you make unarmed strikes? You deal bludgeoning damage equal to 1d4 plus your strength modifier.
We actually did not set that up as an attack modifier. Just one moment.
I'll say, how do I do that?
I can do that. Just one moment.
All right.
It's name unarmed strike.
Oh, hey, I just popped out the chat.
Yep. And then
how
it was.
How do I get rid of the pictures on the main?
Hit the cog and
where are you seeing this hooves as a natural weapon thing?
I got it pulled up on the 5e tools.
Did I forget to add that as a feat?
It's a racial thing from Centaur.
I must have forgot to add that to your character sheet.
Hooves. Your hooves are natural melee weapons, which you can use to make unarmed strikes. If you hit with them, you deal bludgeoning damage equal to 1d4 plus your strength modifier instead of the bludgeoning damage normal for an unarmed strike.
And they would use the strength modifier, and you are proficient for it.
Carl, look at my
range 5 feet. It's 1d4 plus strength modifier.
Crow.
All right. Yeah.
Look at my screen.
So how do I roll that one then?
It should be set up properly now, so you can just click it in your...
Nine.
I see it.
You see my screen?
I've also got two blank spots I don't know how to get rid of.
Right here.
I got them for you.
Alright,
that works. So now you can just click unarmed strike, and it should roll.
Yep, I got rid of those.
Although, I gotta change that. That is going to be called horsey stomp.
also, I mean, another thing from Santo as well, involving hooves. If you move at least 30 feet straight toward a target and then hit it with a melee weapon attack on the same turn, you can immediately follow that attack with a bonus action attack with your hooves.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
That charge.
Yeah, that's charge.
So you can just get to fuck everything.
Apparently, I can just run fuckers down.
That's two things I have to add to your features and traits that I forgot about.
Is there a way I can put my character sheet on my other screen?
You can pop it out and then drag it.
That's what I did.
Yeah, I got mine set up as a separate thing too.
Although if you pop it out and then drag it, it makes it a bit buggy when trying to edit things, so be wary of that.
So far, mine's not gone too crazy.
How the fuck do you... Or wait.
Wait. Horse man.
Oh, I did the wrong thing, that's why.
Did you roll the attack? No, you haven't yet.
Not yet, no. I thought you were still messing with shit.
13 will hit. Go ahead and roll damage. I'm setting up the things that I forgot to add to your character sheet. One. Okay. Five.
Bludgeoning.
Five bludgeoning damage, which wasn't set. So which one are you attacking? Oh, the one that's already wounded?
Yeah.
The one this kills the rat.
So I horsey stomp.
Because it had one HP.
So yeah, I did what I wanted. I pranced over and horsey stomped the fuck out of it. It was a good day.
You flamboyantly.
I am a bard.
As far as you can tell, you have successfully cleared the larder of the rats. You don't know for sure, though. So, Pimpus, it is your turn. You can see the entire larder except for a small area that is still in shadow.
What was our original mission again?
To clear this out.
Rats.
To clear the rats. But you don't know exactly how many rats were in the larder. So there could be some hidden ones that haven't fought yet. You don't know.
It would take a while to guess, say there's still some hiding.
The thing says that I get to light up to 60 feet to a new spot within range, right? And it's a 10-foot.
That is on your action, yes.
I would like to send my light bulb orbs out in the...
You would not be able to see there because the casks are still blocking you.
But
so,
could you not send it here and light it?
No, I can send it straight forward, and then it would allow the little elf halfling looking
character
see it.
I would be able to see to about here. My character would.
Yeah. So.
Okay.
So it would only reveal two blocks, pretty much.
Very helpful.
Is that what you're doing?
Yes, sir.
All right, just one moment. I gotta reveal that.
I'm also setting up some background music, because why not?
Sure. All
right. Lord of the Rings soundtrack.
They just need to have epic sax playing in the background at all times.
Alright.
Alright, it's my turn.
Okay. Pavel, your turn.
Alright, let's see.
Shine your light from here.
Or just move there. You can do that. You have the move speed.
I mean, that's what I was getting to.
Yeah. All right. Yeah.
All right. As far as you can tell, having just moved there, the larder is clear.
Oh, God. I can see through the wall. Yeah. I can see into the void.
I got a little overzealous with the...
God damn, your light's better than I thought it was.
And with that... Ilaria appears at the door and gestures for you all to approach. So Ilaria's up here on the stairs. Turn is over, so you can move as you want. Yeah.
Right, so. Also, I was going to do this on myself. Wow.
Okay.
What is with me rolling eights on D8s? Every single time, it's been max.
You are now at full health.
Victory bagpipes. Bam. Which apparently there is also an epic bagpipe guy.
Of course there is.
Oh my god, I need to look that up.
I got you.
Alright. Once everyone is over here.
I voted D8 like 3 times. Oh, and every single time it's been an 8.
I have to just leave this playing in the background.
It's so low quality, though.
You just need the music. You don't need anything else of it.
No, the sound is low quality.
Yeah, you don't need to do that to get back to where everyone else is. Turn order is over, so you can just move as you want. All right. Ilaria congratulates you and reveals that this was all a test. That she placed the rats in the larder to test your combat prowess.
I cast Unseen Servant to smack her in the ass.
It does not work. There was 6 rats and 6 members of the party, so you each now get 25 experience.
Alright, where do I put that at?
On your character sheet where it says core, next to your alignment and below your background, it says experience points.
So 25?
Yep.
Alright.
Easy enough. I almost did math, because like usually I have to add it up and divide it by the party, but it worked out because every rat was worth 25 experience and there was 6 rats, so.
Everything worked out. Where is it again?
Your character sheet where it says like your class, race, alignment, that box on the bottom right, experience points.
Yeah, yep. Beyond a core.
Alright, and with that, you have passed Ilaria's test.
Nigga, fuck your test.
I'm going to assume you didn't say that out loud.
I did play the bagpipes, though, marching back to the door.
And she whisks you out of the larder towards something else. Just one moment.
This is scarier than the rats!
Of course, scarier than rats.
All right. The next few months pass without incident until one morning you wake up and Ilaria has passed away.
Oh.
I cast Unseen Servant to grab a boot.
You just really want to grope the elf, buddy, don't you?
Whoops. That was the wrong page. The wrong page.
My question is, why is your servant doing it and not you?
All right. Welcome to Parabor, a frontier village of diverse miners and adventurers. This community's economy is fueled by silver in the Karagon Ranges, mithril in the Icebound Peaks, and explorers like you who scout the Merriam Vale for treasure. The Karagon Ranges cut Parabor and the Merriam Vale off from the rest of the Kingdom of Skylark, where King Raziel Fortwith II rules a prosperous civilization. While this small village does fall under his domain, he largely ignores it. just a moment. Its operations... What?
Nothing.
Its operations instead are in the hands of Governess Judith Seagarten, who keeps a small guard and can raise a larger militia of townspeople if any trouble comes along. She lets the villagers keep to herself, to themselves, coming around with her guards once a year to collect their taxes. The dangerous jobs and remote location of Perabor attract more than just miners and adventurers. Plenty of people running from something, be it the law, a shady past, or an angry ex-lover, come to Perabor for refuge from their previous life. This is a village where people ask where you're going, not where you came from.
This is kind of relevant to my backstory. But
go 3 days ago, a large renowned man, many
you're cutting out died. Real bad.
Yeah, you're cutting out hard.
I am?
Yeah, broken.
I shouldn't be.
You were.
Yeah, sound good now.
Okay. 3 days ago, Ilaria Feywing, a renowned mentor to many famous adventurers, died. She was known in the Merriam Vale as the Master. You were her final pupils. The ancient elf who taught you secrets of combat, magic, and wilderness survival, that was supposed to be two words together, passed away in her sleep on the same night that she told you your training was complete. You had not even begun to look for work when the news of her death came to you. Though the master was over 800 years old, she was lithe and energetic. It seemed like she could have lived another 8 centuries. Per the instructions of her last will and testament, Ilaria was buried quickly in a simple ceremony, while many who live in Perabor came to see the master laid to rest. You were her only students able to attend given the short notice. Golana, the local dwarf priestess who runs the Holy Beacon, Perabor's Temple of the God of Light, Lux, asked each of you to say a few words about Ilaria in eulogy by sharing a favorite memory of an unexpected lesson the elf taught you. What memory do you share at the funeral? Going again, same order as before, starting with Pavel.
Sum that up again?
You're sharing your favorite memory of Ilaria, whether she taught you something unexpected or did something nice for you, as sort of a eulogy for her funeral.
Mm-hmm. I need a moment to think.
Take your time.
Can I go?
No. We're going in the order that I decide.
Well, if he wants to go for it.
Okay, well, go ahead then.
When I stumbled into her big house, I was just a fucking mess. Just wanted some ass. And this little cunt, she put me into the sting with rats. I hate rats. And later, she called me a good boy.
Okay, then. Those were very nice words for a funeral. I believe you can continue until CD says he's done. So, Pimpos, it would be your turn. What favorable memory of Ilaria would...
You're crying about rats in a basement. She shoved them up my ass. I don't know what the hell. I would have preferred just going back to the basement. Them ass rats.
This is not what I expected, but I'm going to go ahead
and really?
It's funny. That doesn't sound like a favorable memory. That sounds like torture.
You don't know what he's into. That's King.
But I'll always miss her rats.
Ass rats.
All right. Sajuk, do you have any favorable memories of Ilaria before she died?
She was a good sparring partner. That's all I got.
Okay. That is a nice memory. Brody, what about you?
Plays bagpipes.
I will definitely be playing the bagpipes finishing the funeral, but the story I will share would be the one of when we met. My drunken debacle leading through the town, pissing off half the guards, and then drunkenly stumbling through her front door thinking that it was the tavern.
And she took you in.
And took me in and, you know, took care of the guards instead of, you know, setting me on fire.
Which she very well could have done because she was a world-renowned mage.
Yeah, which all right. All know that she definitely could have done.
Pavel, have you thought of what you wanted to say?
Because as soon as he tells his thing, I will play, you know, whatever
taps
that...
on the bagpipes?
Yes, I will play whatever that song is that is in every single sad movie.
I'm pretty sure you can play music. April
20. I'm just going to assume you're playing taps on the bagpipes.
Yes, I don't know how to roll for the performance of that. Or do I? Apparently I roll a goddamn 20. So I am bringing everyone to fucking tears.
You rolled a 16, not a nat 20, because you have plus 4. But still pretty good performance.
Either way, I bring everyone to tears.
Hold on, I got
Pavel
this.
Still seems to be thinking, so Zandy is going to pipe up. I remember the time that she made me a cake, and it was really good. That's all I've got.
Fucking shitty ass elf.
That's where my ass rats went.
And now we're just waiting on Pavel.
Hold on, coach.
She...
Hold on, coach. Wait, no, go on.
Okay. She assisted me through a time of uncertainty at times. Between loss of my father from unknown causes and wishing to find guidance between survival and the information I was getting from the fuck. I got lost.
You're putting a lot more effort than we all did.
It sounds like this guy got drunk before the eulogy.
I probably did.
Actually,
be right back real quick.
Wow, just cut you off.
Almost hot in here.
All right, I'm back.
Okay.
Okay. Fuck, I lost my voice.
Alright, I'm just gonna do this then.
I wanna get half as shit faced as this guy is right now.
something.
Whatever he had, I want some.
Death is a natural end of life, something, I hold no pity.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Alright, I got this, coach.
Alright.
Hold on. No!
May the Raven Queen serve her well.
God fucking damn it. Anyway, let's continue on. As you are all exiting the Holy Beacon where you gave this eulogy, Yelsa Hodwick, the only solicitor currently working in Perebor, approaches. The middle-aged gnome woman pushes up her half-moon spectacles, wiping tears from her eyes. Wiping tears from her eyes as she embraces you in a hug, one by one. Barely holding back historical tears. Hysterical.
Historical tears?
Hysterical tears.
Tears of history.
Miss Feywing spoke fondly of all of you. In fact, you were all mentioned in her last will and testament.
Oh yeah, free shit.
If you have time today, would you please stop by my office? I know it is a lot to ask, but Yelsa cannot finish her sentence as the tears finally pour out of her. She walks away from you, honking into her handkerchief. Please stop by later, she manages to get out through the tears.
You got it, Elsa.
What do you guys do?
Free shit.
Guidance.
For now, you can explore the town a little bit, because you have a bit of time before Yelsa composes herself.
I overzealously pat her on the back like a big dumb wood.
Nearly. Actually.
Go ahead and... Go ahead and roll a strength check on that.
Oh no, Danny. I killed her.
Guidance.
Wait, that's advantage, right?
No, you just roll a d4 and right. Add it.
Right.
Unless someone assists with that, and then you just... Okay, well, we use the first one because you rolled it twice. And then you roll the d4... You make her, your pat on the back is a bit harder than you expected it to be, and she stumbles, looking back at you in confusion before she walks away.
Assault the poor crying woman.
That 18 plus the 4 would have knocked her to the ground, but you rolled the 9.
Damn!
Shower of sparks.
I think that should have been at the drunken party that Mr. Pavel was at.
You do have a bit of time before she gets back to her office and composes herself, so you can...
Let's say we all go to the tavern and get us a drink.
If that's what you want to do.
To the bar!
To the pub!
As I start blowing my horn on the way.
Go ahead and... Roll a perception check, whoever is looking for the pub, and if you want, you can assist them, so...
I will do that. I'll have to do guidance on myself.
And you have assistance, so it would be advantage.
Yep, and I also have bonus intuition.
Where do you just do a random perception roll?
It would be under yours. Okay, well that's...
Fucking hell.
Never mind, they fucking found it.
Down a couple streets from the temple, you find a pub filled with other mourners of the master's death. It is a very packed pub, but you do manage to squeeze in and find a table for the six.
I lean in and ask Pavel, was this the pub he was at last night? He found it awfully drunk.
Yes, that, whatever you had, we need more.
I'll take whatever the little lad over there had.
All right. Well, you are currently sitting at a bar, at a table in a full bar, so no one heard you.
Shit, they didn't hear me.
I will blast my fucking trumpet and get people the bartender's attention. And apparently it fucking got everyone's attention.
Everyone stops and looks at you in disgust as you blare a trumpet loudly. not a single sound fills the air for a few moments after the trumpet quiets.
What's we need a drink over here.
As the
Don't
silence
look at me.
Is happening, as the silence is happening, I holler out, "Thank you for having a moment in silence for our fallen brother."
The bartender glares at you for the interruptive way in which you asked for a drink before he signals that one of the wenches will be over shortly.
I wave happily at him and then, you know, take my seat. Or I guess my, you know, sit down or house down next to it.
I watch the wench intently, winking at her.
She's not there yet.
Alchemy.
What?
Are there any dead within 60 feet of me that isn't behind total cover and isn't protected from divination magic?
No.
There are no zombies in the bar.
You get a strange twinge from one of the bar patrons, but then you realize that he has a zombie hand hanging from a necklace on his around his
Can
neck.
Steal the zombie necklace?
No. It is too packed for you to get over there successfully. Just one moment. I gotta take my hoodie off. It's too damn hot in here.
All right, while he's doing that, we all need to figure out how to get that zombie necklace.
I can cast Cloud Fog. And
all right. After about 5 minutes wait, the wench wanders over carrying a large pitcher of beer as well as six glasses and asks for payment for the beer. How much is a pitcher of beer, CD? I can't find it on 5e tools.
Wait a second. I've got trade by pocket bananas.
You might want that. Use that for a lot of stuff. Anyway, a gallon of ale is 2 silver.
What'd you say, Jane?
Can I charm them to try and get a better price?
A pitcher of wine is 2 silver as well. So.
And while you're doing that, I gotta figure out why the hell my character doesn't have any money.
Centaur. Man, shouldn't I also have that one?
What background do they have?
It's entertainer.
No, the
smuggler.
Okay, smuggler.
I think I just set something up wrong.
Roll 20 only adds the belt patch, doesn't add the gold.
I never added the gold. That's what I set 15 up. 15 gold. Alright. Yeah. Got that fixed now. Thank you.
Entertainer. 15 gold from entertainer. If you're wondering on that.
I say Jinx pays the bill.
Jinx can get us a get Mr. Epic Saxophone Horse.
Are you performing? You have yet to do a performance check, so.
I can cover my own. Actually, no.
You better shake that ass for some free booze.
I don't think.
How much?
I don't know how to add that like you did.
It should be in the character sheet.
It should be fully described out. Hold on, maybe I didn't.
Yeah, I don't think you added that one to me, so I tried to type it in there.
Oh, yeah. I guess I forgot to type that out for you as well.
Isn't it just going to be the same description?
There was just a couple traits I didn't add properly, so. 5e tools, background, entertainer.
Yeah, cause I don't think I've got anything besides the bardic and the ritual casting thing.
Wait, CD, did you ever heal me?
I mean, it's been a few days, so I'm assuming we all healed up and everything.
Yeah, right? You heal on a long rest, okay. Which I didn't even know you were injured.
Yeah, completely forgot, but I'll just add it back.
There you go. Now it's set up right.
You might want to change the source, though.
Source. I already did that.
It says class bard.
Yeah, he's a bard.
That'd be from background.
Definitely. Oh yeah, right. Because it's through his background.
Yep.
I was confused for a second. All right. So if you're going to be using by popular demand, which only covers yourself, it looks like. Although you can get the pitcher of beer for free. You can get the pitcher of beer for free since you are by popular demanding it. You do need to make a performance check.
All right. I don't know if I could break my horn back out for that one.
You just
pissed them off before.
You just click performance in your skill box.
Oh, let's see, where's that at?
Guidance.
14.
It takes a while, but the crowd does eventually get into your performance.
I said guidance multiple times.
Oh yeah, you can roll a d4 as well. Oh. I forgot about that.
So, I guess roll a d4 as well. So
yep.
Yeah.
Oh, I fucked up. That did fuck all.
Well, it's about the same result. It takes a while, but the limited crowd that can see and hear your performance due to the ruckus gets into it and starts to clap along. The bartender, who is paying attention at all times, does notice and gestures to the wench that you specifically can have food and beer for free.
Yes. Fuck all you guys.
So if you are the one ordering the pitcher, that's the word I'm looking for, it will be free rather than if anyone else orders it.
I will take the big pitcher for myself. Fuck you guys.
Big horse body.
Okay then. More.
Exactly. I need large amounts of alcohol to get drunk.
So she brings over a single pitcher as well as a single glass, if you want that, and places it in front of your centaur face.
I thank her kindly, shoot her a nice wink, and then just start to down the pitcher.
Make a charisma saving throw.
Alright, how do I do that?
Charisma?
Constitution, not charisma. They both start with a C, so...
Alright, so just click Constitution.
Oops.
Yep. I forget what the saving throw is for not getting drunk. Hold on one second.
Probably be decent.
Okay, I clicked the wrong thing. Constitution save.
Yeah, you did it right. It's just you rolled low. Oh no, you rolled Constitution the first time. Your Constitution save actually rolled worse than. So it should be on this sheet, I think. Just a moment.
I'd say something like that. Probably
a whole pitcher of beer.
DC 10.
Yeah, you failed. You are significantly drunk.
Since that would usually be the DC for stuff that to avoid exhaustion and all that.
So do I get advantage at least from being centaur and big?
No, you do not, because you do not have a racial or background
Damn.
Trait that would give you advantage.
What if he was a dwarf?
If he was a dwarf, he would have advantage.
I feel like I could argue on just science grounds, but...
I watched the centaur drooling, licking my lip.
So that's the only picture we got, isn't it?
Yep, what? I said you guys had to buy your own beer. That was mine.
Yeah, I was going to use mine.
He did not... You used yours as well, Jinx?
Yeah.
I guess me and him both are just putting on a show there.
I need you to roll a performance check as well.
Guidance.
With guidance, so you get the 1d4 added.
Oh
Lord.
You're about to get, turn the fuck out for your party.
Even if you roll the d4 and get a 4, it's below 10, and I'm going to say 10 is a successful performance, and anything lower they just kind of don't notice.
Big oof.
And if you got a nat 1, they boo you, which you didn't get a nat 1, so.
Big oof.
So mostly the crowd just ignores your attempts to put on a show using your throwing axes.
He's telling very bad jokes.
Yeah, I'd like to imagine I just threw the axe. It hit my head or something.
Sled drop on their foot.
All right, so the wench comes over curious at what just happened, that an axe smacked into the floor, and she is carrying the pitcher with the 6 glasses still. Is someone going to be paying for this, or...
Slap it down here, miss.
I throw marginally
over the price amount of money at her.
It's 10 silver to 1 gold, and a pitcher cap costs 2 silver.
Okay, so. I'll pass her a gold.
Can also get a mug, which is just 4 copper, but it's only a mug.
Yeah, which that conversion is even crazier than the pitcher.
I'll just toss her a gold. Much.
For the whole pitcher?
Yeah.
Would you like your change, sir?
I get change?
You would get 8 silver back unless you let her keep the...
No, I'm asking her.
If you don't want to let me keep it as a tip, then yes.
I like tips.
So, do you want your change back or not, sir?
Sure. As long as you sit down here with me.
I cannot do that. I have people to serve. She hands you back 8 silver from a pouch at her waist and continues walking in the room after setting down the pitcher and its 6 glasses, which you don't need one because you have a drunk-ass centaur, but she still sets the glass down.
Excuse me. Bar winch, I would like 5.
You cut out.
5.
Yep.
You just want 5.
I want 5.
She wandered off.
Well, she can still hear you.
It's up to the DM.
I'm going to go ahead and say she can still hear you because she's not too far away yet.
I think I'm going to use my giant Goliath arms and just cover her.
If I can get 5 pitchers, please.
No. Rather. She continues walking on as if she didn't hear you. All right. So, Zandy looks at you all and then looks at the beer. And then she says, I don't know about you guys, but I'm not much of a drinker given my size.
All right, I'll take yours. Fuck you, horse. You had a pitcher. Drunk asshole.
Hey, horn boy.
You're drunk. I'm not drunk.
Just punches your snout.
Real quick, CD. Jeweler's tools use intelligence, right?
It depends on what you're rolling for.
Oh, well, I'm just trying to get them set up properly in case Zandy ever wants to make something.
Yeah. For the most part, it'd often be intelligence, but... let's just limit it to query and, all that, because it could have other uses as well.
How much do I need to drink to get drunk?
It depends on your charisma saving throws, or not, constitution.
Well, I had my mug and then your mug.
Well, one mug... for an orc is not going to get them drunk, even if they are not experienced with alcohol.
And one pitcher for a centaur won't either, but he's still drunk.
Yeah. Actually, Joel's tools, I think you should be alright to set to intelligence.
Alright.
Because the two main things they can be used for is Arcana, which is intelligence, or investigation, which is also intelligence.
Alright. Just making sure. And then... I mean, that's his fault for rolling badly on the con save, so.
Also, a fun thing with jewel stores as well, you can identify gems and determine their value at a glance without any rolls.
Yep. I remember that.
I guess I'm not.
You do not get even close to drunk. The two beers seem to have
literally
zero effect on you.
By the way, I'm only paying for just a single mug for myself and a modest meal, which is 3 silver.
All right.
He did buy, you know, like the mug for the table, I thought.
Yeah, I bought the
pitcher.
Whole table.
Yeah, the pitcher's for the whole table.
Oh, that's going to pay me.
Yeah, I'm just the drunk asshole who bought, you know, got his own for free and then downs it.
The food, however, you will have to pay for, which she will be over again in a few minutes to take an order.
Yeah, which will be a modest meal.
I want pretzels.
Shut up, horse. Right. I'll punch you in the snout.
Aside from the meal, which she delivers, and are you paying with 1 gold, and then do you want your change, or...
For me?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's actually pretty true. I already turned off my sheet for conversions and all that, so...
Okay, so she takes the 1 gold, gives you 7 silver back, and then walks off to tell the...
It should be 6 silver and 4 copper. Or six silver and 6 copper. Because I was also getting a single mug on my own.
Oh, right. Okay.
Yeah.
So 6 silver and 6 copper. You gave her what? Yeah. Okay. That works out.
Yeah.
I'm okay, guys. Don't worry about me.
I would like 5 pitchers of mead.
She again ignores you, as you don't seem to be loud enough to catch her ear as she's walking away.
Hey, being a halfling, it sucks. Horn boy, blow a horn.
Please blow don't.
Kyle. Please don't.
Kyle, I'm just picturing you going full horse and just smashing your snout into a plate of food.
I might. I am drunk.
And... 10 minutes later, she returns with the modest meal as well as the pitcher of beer and sets them in front of you, Pavel.
Yeah, thank you.
Sandy.
Can I get food?
Go ahead and roll a charisma check? No.
I mean, I still should get free food from my popular demand, right?
Go ahead and roll a persuasion check.
Persuasion.
Yeah, I'm...
For persuasion, I guess?
Yep. Just a straight persuasion check.
Okay, all right. I thought I got, you know, free food and drink from the popular demand. But...
Well, this is to see if she actually hears you and listens. Because it's a loud tavern.
Oh, no.
Apparently, I completely slurred trying to say anything.
All right, and then after the meal is finished and the beer has been drunk, which everyone who's drinking glass, you're not, well, pretty much everyone other than you, Pimpos, would be capable of taking a single glass. And Zandy isn't drinking any. Pimpos, are you drinking a mug of beer?
I would like five.
Yes, he drank.
5 pitchers, yes, damn.
Are you playing Pokemon?
Too bad, you're getting beer.
That's all you got.
So are you going to drink some beer with your newfound...
Yes, I will drink some beer. I'd like to fill up my flask, too.
Newfound. Okay, well, go ahead and make a constitution saving throw. With one moment, I want to make sure of something.
Duh, he fucked.
Yeah, he's definitely fucked.
Is that guidance?
You see guidance on saves.
Oh, right.
I'd need to do Bless for that, which is a spell slot.
Alright, you don't get too drunk, although you do experience a mild buzz, since it was only 1 mug of ale. You are just buzzed enough that the world is spinning, but you can... keep your thoughts together in a proper way, so to speak.
Unlike our horse friend.
I cast Dancing Light!
Okay, well, it does nothing because the tavern is lit enough already. and you don't want to waste a spell slot on dancing lights.
Cantrips. I don't think you use one, does it?
Oh, right. That's a cantrip. Well, it still doesn't do anything. All right. And once the food is finished and the beer is all drank, you realize that you have wasted a lot of time here and you still need to visit Yelsa at her office.
Crap, what time of day is it?
It is about noon.
God damn, we're starting early.
Someone's been in the bar for a couple hours at this point.
So somebody should guide the drunk centaur there. I want my free shit.
Or someone could... Don't we have... Does anyone have cure disease in this party? Or whatever it is?
I don't think I have
it. If you give me a long rest, I can have it.
All right. Well, you realize...
Don't you know time we gotta go over to home bitch's place?
You realize that you're not going to get anything done with a drunk-ass centaur, so you ask for lodging off of his bill because...
Oh, actually...
Hmm?
I have Shelter of the Faithful, which I could get help with that then.
I say we shove him in the back alley.
Okay, well... There isn't a... temple to the Raven Queen around. The only temple you know of is the temple to Lux, the goddess of light. But since they are religious as it's only people who share. And there is no temple to the Raven Queen, as far as you can tell. You can do an investigation for that if you want, but it would take a while, and you would have to leave the tavern.
So who's the drunkest among us?
The centaur.
Definitely
he's the only drunk one.
Who's the sober?
Pumpkinpus is slightly drunk, but not drop-dead drunk like
the centaur is. I am trembling and flaring.
Is he able to walk?
Actually, wait, I'm wrong. I need to have second level spell slots for lesser restoration.
Ah, so you can't even do that even if you get a long rest?
Yeah.
So the next goal is just to drag my drunk ass to her and hope I don't do anything stupid.
Can he walk?
Hmm?
Jinx asked if Gorilla can walk.
He can, but not very well.
All right.
Everybody get on all sides and guide me.
Walking on four legs while drunk. Obviously not a good idea. So
lift him up with my strength.
You quickly realize that...
All right, so charge.
You, as a party, quickly realize that having a drunk-ass centaur is not going to be very good for trying to get through the town. And... Zandy asks if they could stay for a few hours to get a rest and help the centaur recuperate.
While he's doing that, I'm going to still try and get more booze.
Which you are refused because it is just too busy to service that. It got even more busy by noon as even more people came in for lunch. So now the place is almost impossible to walk through. There's that many people. Which you would be surprised.
Being forgotten.
No, you're being carried. I'm going to go ahead and say you're being carried by Nunga because you are small halfling friend.
I just got him up on my shoulder.
I'm picturing you just cradling him like a baby.
As far as I'm concerned, I'm still asking for more booze.
You are. Just glad being cradled by like a baby.
So
where did the winch go?
She is currently servicing another table that you cannot get to because it's too packed.
Did I just pee on the back of your neck? I'm sorry, bro.
Anyway. Oh, what was I saying?
We're rest.
I spur him on like a horse. Giddy up, little horsey.
Oh yeah. One moment.
Get along, little doggy.
Yeah. All right.
Say one more thing, I'm gonna drop you on your head.
So, are you trying to get the free rooms as off of the drunk-ass centaur's performance?
Yes, I can see if we can do that, since I already, you know, got my food and everything for it.
Yes.
All right. Brody, roll a charisma check at disadvantage. Or a persuasion check, rather.
Guidance? This isn't going to go well.
No, it's not.
At disadvantage.
Guidance?
All right. So, do I get the guidance buff from that? Was it?
You D4? Roll the D4 and then add it as the guidance.
All right.
Okay.
So my drunken slurring, I fucked up. Can I use the bed?
They don't seem too impressed by your sob story. Your seeming sob story.
Apparently, the most sober person here. How much is it for life?
You're not the most sober person here.
Zandy would be the most sober person because she didn't drink any at all. Even though the rest of them are not drunk at all.
Fuck Zandy.
All right. You can try again. And if someone assists you, it would just be a straight persuasion check then, rather than disadvantage. Because they can help you formulate your words.
I'll try to translate his drunken bullshit.
Into dumb.
My charisma's not good, but I can provide guidance.
I was like, my charisma's good. I'm just drunk as shit.
I don't even know.
So you now can make a... Okay.
Oh, yeah, I have decent charisma.
Don't even need the guidance, as that will that will succeed, and they will sigh at your second attempt to get rooms for you and your friends, and then lead you and your party upstairs. This will be funny. To the beds. Brody, I need you to make a acrobatics check.
Is it at disadvantage or anything?
Guidance. He still has guidance, by the way.
At disadvantage, but you can apply guidance to it again with another D4 roll.
Thank God my acrobatics is high. Shit.
That was a nat one. So you take a single step. I don't think even with guidance it will fix the critical failure. So
yeah,
no,
I failed on all of it.
Yeah, so, I'm fucking up there now. Failure is on one to nothing when it comes to ability checks.
Oh, darn it.
Yeah.
You managed to get about halfway up the stairs, or no, a quarter away up the stairs. If it was a higher check, it would have been halfway. But you sense the world literally spinning around you faster than you can perceive, and nearly fall backwards down the stairs.
Oh, shit. Nearly.
Yes, nearly. He does manage to catch himself at the very last second and land on his feet miraculously.
Yes, I am a practiced drunk tumbler.
Just raise your hands like a fucking
He will
gymnastics.
Definitely need help getting up these stairs, but mind you, he weighs 300 pounds without his gear.
I would have lift that all, so
everyone, yeah, pull me up the stairs.
The Sajuk?
I think a Goliath would be able to carry.
Sajuk and Nunga Nunga could both carry him with a effective strength check from the both of you.
Alright, slap him on our shoulders.
Or no, wait, did I get the weight wrong?
Oh
no, he weighs 900 pounds.
Because
I said Sajuk's weight and not Brody's weight.
Roll your strength.
With his gear, that's 950 pounds.
Push, motherfucker.
Roll your strength.
Push, pull, push, pull.
Guidance. I don't know if it'll do anything, but...
You can both roll strength with advantage, and we will go off whoever rolls higher.
Though. Oh, I didn't roll advantage.
Also got roll normal well. Again.
Both you, Bammy, and Sajuk can roll. It doesn't have to be a save. You can just roll straight strength. So that's a 22 okay. from Bammy,
do I have
and then
guidance?
You roll a second one, Jinx.
Do I have guidance?
You both have guidance, but you wait for a second.
Yeah, I'm giving it to whoever.
All right, we're going off of Nunga Nungas, and then okay. now roll the four.
Yeah, the only limit for guidance is that it's concentration, so I can only concentrate on one at a time.
Okay.
25, with a 25, takes about 10 minutes, I would say, but you do manage to push, prod, and pull the centaur up the stairs successfully. The wood floor below him seems to creak and groan with each step he takes, but it shows no signs of collapsing. The wench who was leading you, unimpressed with... Oh no, it's the bartender, not the wench. The bartender who is leading you, unimpressed and slightly frustrated at how long that took, leads you each to an individual room so you can all sleep separately for a short rest. Because that's all you paid for, basically.
Will I fit in the bed?
I am going to rule yes, because you can sleep on your side.
All
right. He's still a horse.
Although the bed will, just like the floor, creak and strain under your weight.
I'm just seeing the legs collapse and it's just falling on the floor.
Me laying on just a smashed bed drunk.
All right, if that's what you want to. Go ahead and roll more acrobatics, again with disadvantage. And because you are in your own room separate from Pavel, you cannot have guidance for it.
Oh, I did get 14, though.
You manage to climb into the bed without much incident. It almost breaks under your weight, but manages to hold, except while you are trying to get comfortable, a careless movement of one of your hooves knocks a piece of the banister to the floor. Or the headboard, rather.
Like a glove.
And now the whole party gets a short rest, which short. I forget what the... Yeah, you did not ask for a long rest. You yeah. do not have the time for a long rest.
Okay.
Because by the time you wake up, the solicitor's office would be closed.
Normal short rest, unless we want to go with the faster one, is an hour.
Alright, you sleep for an hour.
I don't think that's enough time to not be drunk.
Brody, you can make another constitution roll.
Alright, normal?
Yeah.
God damn it! Wait, that was a save.
You... Oh yeah, that was not a... Oh yeah, it would have to be a save, because you are trying to save yourself from the poison effect of the alcohol.
You drunk fucking horse.
You are still moderately drunk, but less drunk than before. You are now capable of walking without falling over.
Yeah, I did it.
Can he speak properly?
He can speak, but he will have a slur.
As long as he's coherent.
I mean, the level of coherence differs per person. Nunga Nunga isn't exactly as coherent as someone like...
As long as he's not slurring trying to ask for food. Give me
and
food!
With that, your time resting is over, and you all emerge from your rooms... Other than you, Brody, which you need to, again, make a acrobatics check at disadvantage.
Please tell me you just smashed.
Fuck.
You attempt to get out of bed, and in the process, collapse half of it to the ground. So two of the legs are now broken underneath you, while the other two are...
All right, so what I'm hearing is I need to just calmly sneak out of the bar.
They know which room you were in. They know which room you were in, so...
They don't know who I am.
Your party has repair. You don't know.
But he can disguise on his way out.
Yeah. I disguise myself so they don't know it's me walking out.
Zandy, when you all appear in the hallway, pipes up that they need that we all need to get to the solicitor's office.
What are we waiting for? Let's go!
Alright, you approach the stairs, gotcha. And... you didn't need... Actually, yeah, you probably would have, because you can't exactly apply a disguise while you're drunk. You manage to haphazardly disguise yourself with a cloak you find on a wall, as well as some hair off of the floor that you turn into a fake mustache.
Fantastic.
Still doesn't really prevent you from looking like a centaur.
But it worked.
It might be enough to get me out of here without having to pay for my bed.
It's a different
centaur. We'll see. I don't know. We'll see. You approach the stairs and start to descend it one by one with Brody behind everyone because... Oh, no, wait. Brody should be in the front. I was just thinking, if he falls, it's going to crush everyone.
He started that way. That's the way we're doing it. God
damn. Yep. All right.
I want a cushion.
Brody is the last one to attempt the stairs. Again, I need an acrobatics check.
Don't you fucking dare.
Yes, it will be at disadvantage.
Oh, thank fuck.
Right. That was a good roll. You managed to get down the stairs, although no one was looking, and you don't know how you did it yourself, so no one can tell you how the hell you managed to get down those stairs without falling on your ass or falling down them.
Majestic forces.
You just, 1 second you're at the top of the stairs, the next second you're at the bottom, and you don't realize.
I made it. That's all that matters.
Zandy then leads the way out of the back room to the front of the bar, which is now less packed, has a moderate amount of people, though. And Brody, when you approach the doorway to go through, I need you to roll stealth check at normal, because the crowd is just enough that it offsets your disadvantage that you would have otherwise.
All right. Don't screw me this time.
You manage to sneak through amongst the rest of the party, although once you get towards the door, the bartender locks eyes with you and stares at you curiously, knowing that you are the same centaur that went up there to begin with. Since your disguise is not exactly a good one.
Is he going to stop me from leaving?
No, he doesn't know that you did anything wrong yet.
I cast Cloud Fog.
What? Why?
You managed to get out of the pub without incident.
Nailed it. The disguise is 100% required.
But you realize that you do not know where the office of the solicitor is.
Shit. Alright, so everybody needs to start searching for it.
Whoever has the highest perception score can...
Hello. Hello.
Or would it be an investigation? It would be investigation, because perception... Yeah, it would be investigation. Whoever has the highest intelligence score...
Oh, this is totally me.
Well, not me.
I have 14 for intel.
I got 6.
Can make an investigation check with assistance...
Whoever will be rolling it, I'll use guidance on.
So Pimpus, go ahead and roll a investigation check with advantage.
And guidance.
So you toggle on the advantage and then roll it.
There'll be intelligence roll. Not a save, Crow.
Investigation is below your saving throw.
Yeah, it's in the skills there. should be somewhere in the middle.
Yeah, between medicine and intimidation.
It's right next to wisdom.
And guidance.
So roll D4. A D4, and then we'll add that to the investigation check.
You guys gonna do that? I'm gonna grab a drink here real quick.
19. It takes you about 2 minutes, but you do manage to find the solicitor's office by the giant sign hanging above the building that says solicitor, just down the road from the pub. Do you go inside?
Yes.
All right. One moment, please. I have to get a drink before I start reading, because there's something I need to read, so anyone. Be right back.
Mm-hmm.
We can go ahead and just take like a 5 minute break, get up, stretch, go to the bathroom.
Eat ass.
Sort of thing.
I'm back. What I miss?
5 minute break.
We're just taking a quick 5 minute break, getting a drink, stretching, etc.
We found the office.
All right. All right, good.
We're just about to walk in.
Oh, yeah, speaking of which, I need an athletics check.
Oh, dear God.
Athletics?
Yes.
Or acrobatic?
At disadvantage. No, this time it would be athletics.
All right.
Got it.
You are just walking.
With advantage, you said?
With disadvantage. So roll again.
Oh, shit.
You'll take the one on the left then.
I guess.
The disadvantage one, somehow I did better.
Also, guidance as well. I already mentioned that.
I did already say to roll it again with advantage the first time, so I'm going to go ahead and say the 15 counts.
Woohoo!
And then you can add guidance, a 17. You do manage to clop along the cobblestone road without falling over.
Just drunkenly prancing?
Yep, pretty much. Although there is a couple times where your hoof gets stuck on a misplaced cobble and you almost fall straight forward flat on your face.
I have a question. Is it still disguised?
Yes. Quick 5 minute break now.
I am keeping the mustache on.
Just proudly prancing with your mustache.
Yeah, with my weird ass mustache and, you know, somebody else's cloak, apparently.
Let me see if I can't find a bite of food. Be right back.
I found cookies.
Muted.
Oh, fuck, it's just taking a break. I'll go take a piss real quick.
Thank you. Alright, we got about 3 minutes until the grape, the break.
I have returned.
Is done. Unless everyone returns before the 5 minutes is up, and then we'll just continue then.
Also, one thing I want to mention, Alchemy. I understand forgetting about it, but definitely want to remember about opportunity attacks from NPC enemies.
Yep. Did anyone move out of the range of an enemy?
A few times.
Oh. My bad.
Yeah, I didn't want to say anything in the heat of moment.
It's all right. I will remember that next time.
Such a shitty DM.
Hey, it's my first time, so shut up. We're just waiting on... Jinx and Bammy. And we got about 1 minute since I said the break started. But they can go a bit over if they want.
They can poop.
Yeah, okay, they're gonna have to go over a bit.
I don't know if they were, I just said that.
Oh.
So I didn't get to spend none of my money. Damn halfling don't get noticed anywhere. Fucking discriminate.
Well, you're going to need to spend that money soon, because we got something interesting coming up.
I did not break that bed. I don't know what you're talking about.
That's not what I'm talking about, but...
That's exactly what he's talking about, but...
That is something that will come up to bite you soon. You don't know when, but soon.
They have no idea it was me. It could have been anything. Sure.
They know which bed, they know which room to they gave to the centaur, and they will know that the bed was broken.
It's kind of obvious.
Are there centaurs in this town?
Chances are maybe there's one other, but...
It was that guy.
You exactly disguise yourself to look like them, so...
You don't know that. They might have just a really shitty mustache.
If you knew what they looked like, you could have potentially tried to disguise yourself like them, but you have not seen them, so.
It was not me.
Anyway, we're just waiting for... So how's it? Have you guys liked it so far, since it's my first time?
Yeah, I'm into it.
DMing?
Left for food, ended up taking a shit, still don't have food.
Oh, hey, I was right.
All right, we're just waiting on Jinx, then.
I have cookies, so I'm a fat fuck.
I don't have anything. Except for lemonade.
I don't have anything I don't have to cook.
Jar of peanut butter. Nom, nom, nom.
I've been snacking on candy. I really shouldn't be.
Badass. Maybe send yourself into a coma.
Yeah, don't do that.
No, if you do, I'm coming down there, and I'm just putting my dick in your mouth. You have been warned?
I've come to the conclusion that if I haven't put myself in a coma yet, I'm not going in one. Are we all here now?
Okay.
Yep.
We are all here. You enter the solicitor's office. A small bell rings in the doorframe as you enter the solicitor's office. The smell of paper twinges in your nose. Neatly stacked books and files seem to fill every shelf, table, and available surface of the gnome's crowded workspace. Thank you so much for coming, Yelsa's voice chirps shakily behind her desk. She scurries off her chair and says, oh, excuse me, I seriously need to file these. As she picks up papers off the seats of three chairs and couch set up across from her desk.
I will take my seat on the couch.
May I offer you all some tea?
Certainly, please.
I would love some tea. Yes, please.
You say in a drunkenly slurred voice.
No, I'm good, ma'am. Thank you, Kalani.
So you have a centaur taking up the entirety of the couch, three chairs, and the floor. And there's five other people that need to be able to sit.
I'm going to wander around the room, inspecting the books and parchment.
Can I just slap squat? I know I'm wearing scale mail, but I can probably slap squat, hopefully.
Roll athletics check to see if you can...
Guidance.
I could just see him sit down on the floor. Straight athletics check.
Oof. Oof.
That was a nat 1 on your...
No, that was a 2 minus 1.
Oh, and then plus 4, so you got a 5. It looks like. You attempt to squat, wobble for a second, and then fall straight backwards.
You are still way too drunk for this.
I'm just going to walk up, slap Brody in the face, call him a drunk bastard, and sit on my ass on the floor.
So that means I can kick, right? You spooked the horse. Would that be horse's knob again?
Please no. I'm not behind you, and you are sitting down.
I'm more just kind of sprawled on the couch.
Yeah, he's like awkwardly laying sideways.
So you could get kicked by the front legs.
I am not in a position to be kicked.
I'll just accept my fate, and act like I intended to lie on the ground there.
So that's two of the remaining five people. Zandy, seeing the other two sitting, laying on the floor, takes one of the chairs, and her head barely reaches the top of the desk.
I thought the chairs were taken up too.
No.
You said they were.
I said the couch was taken by the centaur, and there was only three chairs. And five people other than the centaur needed to sit down.
Yeah. Whatever, I'm retarded anyway, so I'm sticking with my story.
I'm still wondering if I can kick him from where he's sitting.
No, you can't. Aww. The way you are seated, you would not be able to kick, since your legs are in an awkward position.
For shits and giggles, how much would I have done?
Roll the damage.
And
if you did get the kick off, that was the orc.
It would have.
I'm gonna have to start typing for a minute.
Hey, move closer so I can kick you.
Shut your drunk mouth. Jinx, what are you going to do?
Hey, look, I found dragon porn over here. I found dragon porn, guys.
God damn it.
Damn, right.
And while saying that, Pimpos holds up a...
You're cutting out.
You cutting out again?
While saying that, Pimpos pulls up a very badly drawn picture that he obviously made.
I want to see it.
Anyway. Anyway, after passing out tea to Zandy and I think you wanted some as well, Pavel?
I asked for tea, drunkenly.
Okay, well, to you then. And to Pavel, I believe.
What? Yeah.
Did you want tea?
Yeah.
Okay. Yelsa sits down again. Please delete that.
And
Yelsa unseals a small envelope with the initials EF pressed into its wax seal. As she pulls forth the letter within, the gnome speaks in a grave tone. Now, as I said at the services, Ilaria included you in her last will and testament. She has no family, and you are the only people mentioned in the document. She wanted me to read aloud and then give you the following instructions.
She loved us more.
And this is a rhyming poem that Yelsa will start to read. My gold has dwindled in 800 years, but there's some left, so be all ears. My mansion, my treasures are all yours, if you can open the last of my doors. The vault in the backyard is my final test. You must work together to complete this quest. The door can be opened with strength of the mind, but before you attempt, find the tiles, all 9. 3 are hidden where she creeps and crawls, the one with 8 legs and venomous jaws. Venomous. The one with 8...
That's better.
Those who entrusted to one... Start again. 3 are entrusted to one born of dragons who cannot be reached by boats or by wagons. 3 still are buried with a friend long forgotten who lingers long after her body is rotten. Unlock the vault. Do not delay, for others are hunting my treasure this day. Every moment you wait puts people at risk. So take up the task, and please do be brisk. All will make sense when you open the vault and realize my death was not nature's fault.
I'm
going to copy-paste that, and so you can read it.
Assume spider creature, and then probably we're going to go fly up mountain or something.
Dragons and a spider.
Yep.
We're going to have to dig up our grave.
What?
Yep, we're definitely. I mentioned something about zombies, I'm sure, so we're about to go grave robbing.
The last line of the master's will causes Yelsa to choke up, and she sucks in her breath to compose herself. What could this all mean? Ilaria's property now belongs to all of you. That much is clear. You all remember from your past explorations in the mansion's grounds that there is a stone trap door behind it, and it was always locked and had no key. However, the door did have 9 square-shaped divots in it. Perhaps this is the vault Ilaria's poem refers to.
Let's shag up to the mansion.
There's a couple things I need to show you guys as part of what I just...
Whoa!
Ooh, fancy.
Whoa!
And you can scroll those to read.
Oh, you can zoom in on it. So, up the Murty River is where Spider Bitch will be at. Wherever that's at. Staircase cliffs, I'm assuming, is where the dragon person's at.
Yep.
And I'm still going to assume we need to dig her grave up. I know probably not, but I kind of like want to see where that goes.
Well, for now, we are done, actually.
You what, mate?
Yeah, my voice is almost shot, and I think that was a good enough place to stop, so.
Yeah.
I suppose so. Yeah, back. Yeah, what I'm hearing is we definitely need to go dig a grave up, though.
We will pick up with where you all decide to go, which you will decide next session. Is there any questions or comments you guys have for me?
The next session is
all right.
Same time next week.
Yeah.
Yep, same time next week. 2 o'clock Central, 3 p.m. Eastern.
3 p.m. actual time.
Yeah.
Because we're cool kids.
Yeah. All right.
Yep, works
you
me.
You all have a good day.
Yeah,
it was care. Fun. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
You didn't keep it going long enough. Everyone's still here.
But you'll just stay until I die, so.
I will. I 100% will.